Thank you very much, Chairman Sir, for affording me an opportunity to participate in the bill moved by Sri Bharat Hari Mehtab Ji regarding senior citizens' provision of geriatrics and dementia care bill 2014. If we see the object of the bill, it is discernible from it, and there is no quarrel on the issue that in our country the sizable population of senior citizen is there, and it is also growing day by day. And senior citizens normally suffer from geriatric disorders, and most common them is a cognitive disorder like Alzheimer's disease and other form of dementia. And as on today, there is no such enactment on this subject for giving proper care to the patients. Even the children, in most of the cases, have abandoned their parents suffering from such disease. And from the government side also, the proper care is also required, but in absence of such enactment on the subject in issue, no heed is being given. Now, in view of this is the right time that such an enactment should be passed by this August House. Sri Mehtab Ji has rightly stated in the bill that care units are required to be set up for the senior citizens, and the promotion of medicine education and training is also required in this direction, as well as survey and constitution of such units in the hospital. And the children who abandon their parents or the person suffering from this disease to be provided suitable punishment of 6 months or like that. Basically, the issue related is an issue of human rights and the protection of the human right is, in a democratic setup, the primary duty of the parliament. These are the moral issues, and there is a moral duty on the part of the parliament to protect the moral right of its citizen, like the senior citizen. Our parliament has time to time taken care of the moral issues while exercising its moral duty by way of enactment of matter related to empowerment of the woman, subject related to atrocities against the woman, prohibition of the child marriage, and atrocities against the children. Therefore, there is a corresponding duty and corresponding right, and we are accountable to the public at large, especially the senior citizens, to provide such type of enactment. I would also like to mention that a very bold initiative taken in 2014 by our government under the visionary Prime Minister Sri Narendra Ji Modi, the Union government has made the public the draft National Health Policy 2015. Basically, the policy is the first step in achieving universal health coverage by advocating health as a fundamental right. And it is also provided in this policy that denial of that is justiciable and it can be enforced as it is being done in case of right to education. While it makes a strong case for moving toward universal access to affordable health care services, but there are innumerable challenges to overcome before the objective becomes a reality. But this is a right step of the government. It is true that the current government is spending on healthcare is a dismal only 1.04% of gross domestic product, one of the lowest in the world. This translates to rupees 957 per capita in absolute term. The draft policy has addressed this critical issue by championing an increase in government spending to 2.5% of the GDP, that is 3,800 per capita in the next 5 years. But even this increase in allocation falls short of the requirement to set right of dysfunctional healthcare services in the country. Citing the healthcare system low absorption capacity and insufficient utilization of funding as an alibi for not raising the spending to 3% of GDP is nothing but a specious argument. Insufficient funding over years, combined with other faulty practices, have led to dysfunctional healthcare system in the country. And divided focus is an imperative to strengthen all the elements of healthcare delivery. The failure of the public healthcare system to provide affordable services has been the main reason that has led to increase out-of-pocket expenditure on healthcare. As a result, 63 million people are driven into a poverty every year. So this is a need of the hour, and it is high time that we enactment like this regarding protecting the senior citizen from a serious disease like this. This bill is required to be enacted, and I fully support this bill, and I extend my also thanks to Mehtab ji for bringing this bill. Thank you very much.